In the metals quadrant today, we had a higher close for December copper, closing up a little bit better than a half of 1%, only the fifth higher close in the last 15 sessions. We've had three consecutive weeks lower on that copper futures contract now. As a matter of fact, the week of October 11th, copper was up 10.62%, and these last 3 weeks, copper only missed retracing that entire move by a little bit more than 2.5 cents. On the highs today, we're up almost 1.25%, 4.3735. On the lows, down about 0.9%, 4.2820. And I mentioned already, we settled about 0.5% higher. We've got a story of inventories versus costs lately in copper. While copper inventories continue to rise, so do costs. So as those inventories rise, it pushes on the price of copper, but as the cost to produce copper and smelt copper rises, that holds those prices up as well because it needs to go back into the price of the finished copper. Now the demand has been weakened specifically by the data out of China, but we're gonna get some more data out of China next week. So we'll see if those demand issues persist. Lastly, the inverse relationship between the dollar and copper didn't really have that much of an effect today, but over the weeks it has. The US dollar had its second consecutive up week. Already mentioned, copper's been down three consecutive weeks. The dollar was stronger against the euro, the pound, the Canadian dollar, the Aussie, and the Kiwi this week. All of that affecting the price of copper.